Hello, this is the first tutorial in Ubuntu, about Ubuntu, the operating system of the laptop that you are using or the computer that you are using now, and it's about some basics and the programs, the settings that are available in Ubuntu. I'll go back to the first screen that you most probably will see when you start your computer, your laptop. And it might not look, or for sure it doesn't look exactly the same. The picture here might look different, but what is for pretty sure that at the left hand side of your favorite programs, you've an activities button, your date and time, a couple of settings, and your applications that are installed on the computer. Let's start here, activities. Pressing the activity button shows you which programs are active at this very moment, and that is LibreOffice Impress and the OBS Studio recording program that I'm using right now to show you what's going on my screen. And if you look carefully at the toolbar here, then you see OBS Studio has an orange dot left to it. It means it's active. The same applies for LibreOffice Impress. So even no need to press my activities button, but that's an option. Here I have all the applications that are installed in Ubuntu, and you can get more if you check on the Ubuntu software. You can download and install additional programs if you wish. So we go back to that away, and then here we have a number of settings: my loudspeaker, my microphone, the settings of the brightness of the screen. I have my network settings, I have my Bluetooth on or off, I have my battery, the power settings that say, okay, what do you want? I have a balanced power setting because I want to save my battery more or less whilst having some good performance. You can high performance and power usage are up, then this is standard and reduced performance and reduced power use. I can set, this is nice, you can set your screen blank after you leave your workplace and or inactivity of the screen. Then after 12 minutes it turns the screen off, or dims the screen when the computer is inactive, so to save power. And this one is to avoid people looking at your work or what you're doing when you leave your workplace. All that is pretty much straightforward, so you rather explore yourself. I close this one, and of course you have also settings here, but I will go to that later. And lock, I cannot do this one. Power off and log out will show you the sleep button, then actually the computer remains active but on a low level, and you can quickly restart. Restart is when you just want to do a hard restart of the laptop if one of the programs collapses, or there's other things that you want to. Sometimes it's required after an update, then you have to restart the computer to install the updates. And power off is, of course, switching off totally. Log out, then you log out as a user, switch user. Then if you have a laptop with multiple users, you can change from user. If I press this one now, I have to restart my recording again, so it won't do that. Okay, we have seen this one. All the installed applets are here. It's kind of standard there. Calculator, additional drivers, text editor, and some games and other things. Utilities is nice to see. You can see how your hard disk is utilized, and there's some other programs that are nice to explore. And then it has fonts. So I go back, and then if I press the second dot, it shows you additional programs. Now these are, if you have a program in your applet that you use frequently, you can right click on it and add it to favorites. You see now the settings has moved to this toolbar where your favorites are, and I can remove it again, remove from favorites. I click left click on that remove button. So there's a couple of programs that are favorite for me. For you might be different. That is Firefox, the web browser, Google Chrome web browser, video media player, document viewer for PDFs, LibreOffice Calc, LibreOffice Writer, my files. If I click on this one, I see what's on my desktop, my documents, downloads, music, pictures, documents I've arranged in a couple of subfiles, subfolders, and this actually shows you how is a shortcut to the different options you have. Then let me go to settings, then you see what can be done. Okay, let's start from the top. Wi-Fi, I do have H4C OSIA network, it's connected, and if you have other networks you will see them appearing here, and you connect to those. Network is actually the network with a cable, and VPN, it's not there. Bluetooth, is there any device that you want to connect to, then you can turn it on here. The background shows you the appearance of your desktop. I've chosen this one. If I tick another one, you see it will be a flower here, but I find that not that practical. So I go back to my old background, and then the appearance, you can choose a light or dark appearance. You can change the icon size. You can see at the left that they change these icons, these symbols. So this is for me nice, but you can choose of course different options. And then the dock, this is called the dock with the shortcuts, is the your favorite programs. You can select it, it's left, or if you prefer it the way Windows does it normally, then it's on the bottom, and that is just up to you. Also this is pretty straightforward, and you just have to try, can't go wrong. Notifications is something, okay, what do I want? Not disturb or lock screen notification, you get a notification and a sound when you lock your screen. It's a thing. Search options, if I search for a certain word or a certain term or a certain folder or a file, I can indicate where to look for. Is it in calendar, files, is it in my calculator? Multitasking shows you which programs are active, and then you can actually click on those programs. Applications, we've seen that already. This is the vertical representation of all the programs and applets that you've seen under the button show applications. So I close this one, sorry, go back where I am, settings, applications, privacy, set you what do you want, location, do you want to share your location all the time? I wouldn't do that. File history, for instance, it's kept, so you can easily find your files. Not always necessary to have that on, you can clear your history, but actually it helps you finding files in a more easy way. You'll come to that in the web browser lessons tutorial as well. Then the screen. Here it's okay, when will my screen turn blank without any information on it after 12 minutes of inactivity. Like I said, it was here at the right as well. And then diagnostics. Do you want to send reports if there's a crash or fault or any other issue? Will the computer will send it automatically or manually to the developer of Ubuntu. We go back again. Then online accounts, I skip for now. Sound, you can see, okay, what's there, and you see built-in audio tests in the balance. You see my microphone is now flickering. It means I'm talking. If I'm quiet, nothing here. And then power, we've seen that already. Displays, if I have multiple display, then I can use that one as well. Mouse and mousepad, mouse speed, natural scrolling, touchpad, that is the pad at the bottom of your keyboard. The keyboard layout is English, UK, and then there's some settings here. You can select printers. These ones were once installed and both are stopped. Removable media shows what are you going to do when you plug in a music player or DVD or CD. This is about the color. Accessibility users, default applications. This is practical. You have web, you have your Firefox web browser. Mail is this one, calendar this one, music, VLC media player. You can select others as well, shortcut for video, music, rhythm box or shortcut, but VLC is the most common. Date and time, it's set to the 16th automatic, the zone time zone is Kampala and the time format 24 hours, and this says which a version of Ubuntu you are using. Okay, thank you for your attention. I hope this helps you in using Ubuntu in a good and effective way.